Hello, my name is Stefan Gerhardt. I'm a physicist here at PPPL, and I'm the project director for our ongoing construction project on the National Spherical Torus Experiment Upgrade, which is in this test cell right behind me. Let's go take a look. Fusion is important because it can supply steady power that's not dependent upon weather and environmental conditions like some other kinds of carbon-free power are. A fusion system can make 24/7 electrical power that can be a key part of a future energy economy that's carbon-free. Here we are at the highest elevation within the NSTX-U test cell, and that's the NSTX-U device. To make fusion energy happen, you need a very hot gas. You need the particles to collide hard enough that they'll stick together against their repulsive forces. Any gas that hot will be a plasma. It will be fully ionized, so it will be like a gas that conducts electricity. We accelerate beams of ions, which we convert to beams of neutral hydrogen, and we inject very energetic particle beams through this box into the plasma.
For the NSTX project, we use two neutral beam lines. Each neutral beam line has three ion sources installed per beam line. Each ion source is capable of about 2 megawatts of injection power. So for the NSTX project, we have about a total of 12 megawatts of injection power, and that allows us to reach temperatures of up to 100 million degrees.
It's difficult to keep a fusion reaction running. Being able to confine a plasma so that it's dense enough and hot enough to actually facilitate a fusion process. You've got to have density, you've got to have a lot of heat to get the energy out.
We are looking to confine that gas with magnetic fields. All of our magnets are electromagnets. There are no permanent magnets. So electric current would flow down the copper conductors in the red and make magnetic field that confines the plasma. We'd like to have a perfect sphere of magnetically confined plasma. Turns out the laws of physics don't allow that. So all of our fusion machines are donut shaped. Maybe they're more like a wheelbarrow tire, or in our case, like a cored apple with the hole down the middle, very slender. It turns out the trajectory of the field lines in this spherical configuration is stabilizing to plasma instability. So for both plasma reasons and potentially economic reasons, we've been looking to make the hole down the middle as small as possible. We think that a machine perhaps 3 to 4 times this large, maybe twice the magnetic field strength, could make a fusion reactor.
It's a critical component for these smaller experimental devices and establishing proof of concept that can later translate to large-scale commercial fusion devices that have the potential for us to be able to get to carbon-free energy sources. This is neutral beam line 2. So what you see here is the duct that allows us to transport that neutral beam into the vacuum vessel, which is behind me. Without neutral beam heating, the bulk plasma itself is not dense enough, and we don't get enough heat to actually get more energy, potentially get more energy out than you're putting in. For our neutral beams, there actually is a series of 6 different power supplies that supply each ion source.
This is the apple core. What you're seeing is the casing itself, the metal components, which are made from a high-strength nickel alloy. Covering that are graphite tiles. Graphite is important for us. We put a lot of power into the plasma. That power ultimately comes out. It goes under graphite, which can handle that energy. And if a little carbon gets in the plasma can generally tolerate that. And you can see here the inside of our vessel. The central magnet assembly, the core of the apple, has been removed as part of our construction activities. The skin you see of the vessel is like the skin of the apple. The flesh of the apple is the plasma, and this is as if the flesh were removed. So in there would be our plasma, hotter than the center of the sun.
Thank you for joining me on a tour of the National Spherical Torus Experiment. I hope you enjoy the rest of your time with PPPL today.